That makes a bigger poof than the other one does.
So the first thing I have to do before I can fire this thing is finish cutting out these holes in the kale wool. It's probably kind of echoey sounding because I'm in a enclosed garage. So all I'm gonna do is just take a Sharpie and just trace around the outside of them, maybe. If I can draw a circle. So all I'm gonna do is take a Sharpie and trace a circle around those and cut those out. I don't have to make a wooden stand for my torch. I found these scrap pieces, and if I just stack them on top of each other, they have plenty of slope for the torch to rest on and still be pointed downwards. It's not a drastic angle or anything, but it's enough. All right, so I've gotten those holes cut out of it now. See, I got the two on the lid and the one in the side for the torch. The only thing that has occurred to me is I'm not completely sure about how big these vent holes needed to be. They seem like they'll do the job just fine, especially since I'm only using one torch. I didn't really look at like a recommended size for this. I just kind of grabbed the biggest hole saw we had. If I need to, I can always make them bigger. As of now, the furnace is done being built. It's just got to get, you know, lit. But the problem is it's raining. Well, I don't know that it's raining right now. It was raining pretty good, and it's, I assume, supposed to keep raining throughout the day.
All right, so today is the day when I finally get to relight another furnace. This was the new one that I've built. If you didn't see that in the, yeah, it was the previous video. I built this one out of kale wool. Pretty easy to do. You just, you know, cut circles out, put it in the bottom, the top, wrap it around the sides, and you're good. So if you don't know, my old furnace doesn't work anymore. I don't know why. So we're going to test this one, and I really hope this one works because I'm really excited to get back to messing with some liquid metal again.
That makes a bigger poof than the other one does. I ain't let one of these things in so long and scary again.
Gotta get that thumbnail. So, all right, yeah. Here's that kind of vortex thingy. Whoa, that's hot. That we're supposed to be going for, I believe. That's why I got this thing in there sideways so it kind of spirals around. All right, so I'm gonna put this top on it. Let it get to cook, and it is currently 6:14. I'm probably only gonna give it 30 minutes to make a difference in that aluminum. If I don't see any changes with the aluminum, I'm gonna assume I ain't fixed the problem. Because I have, back on one of my first furnaces, when it worked like it's supposed to, I have melted down aluminum in somewhere around 15, 20 minutes. Now it's only coming out one side. What's the deal with that? Is it because of the way it's spinning and that's where it's coming up at? Okay, nope, now it's out the other side. So my biggest concern right now is this. If you watch, you see right now the inside of the furnace is completely filled with fire. But if I set this on there, you can look on the inside. Kind of gets dark in there. So the problem we're having with the last one was fairly interesting. I don't really know how to describe it. But it's like the propane was, this is on the old furnace. It's like the propane was shooting in the bottom, but it wasn't really on fire till it was venting. It's like the whole inside of the furnace was just filled with propane, but it wasn't on fire till it exited. And that's what I'm serious now. Now I'm worried that's what this one's doing because it's so dark in there. And you can see there's obviously fire coming out of it. But then if I take this off, lights right up. So I don't know if I need bigger vent holes or how that's supposed to work, but I'm gonna let this one go. I'm just gonna leave it sitting. See what 30 minute gives it. And if it doesn't work, then I'll do some more research from there. So this thing has gotten red on the inside now, and well, if it'll focus. I don't know if you can see it, if I can get this camera just right, or this phone just right. Zoom in, okay, you can't see it. Nah, but the pot in there, the metal pot, whatever, that I use for a crucible, is getting red. I mean, it's a steel pot. That means the aluminum's net. The steel's not going to go anywhere. But the inside of this thing is red again. That means it is getting hot. Thank goodness. I'm assuming, really, really hoping this thing is working. I'm going to give it just a little bit longer just to make sure that that aluminum is about to turn. And then I'm going to set up these molds, and then we should be able to pour something tonight. Oh, yeah, look at that. Oh, yes. That aluminum has collapsed. Now, I cannot reach down in that vortex, obviously. But that aluminum, yeah. We're pouring something tonight. I just dropped a few more things in there. You can see that shiny stuff. That's the new pieces I just dropped in. It is liquid now. I lit this thing up at 614. At 633, I pulled the lid off of it. It was liquid. 19 minutes, and this thing was ready. So I'm gonna let this stuff melt down, see how much is in there. I just set up my mold a little bit, kind of set it up in a hurry, gonna go back, make sure it's all right. All right, so I can tell we're almost out of propane. I cannot do anything to make this thing send it any more propane or anything. It is definitely, it's definitely really close to empty. I can tell by picking it up. It's honestly got me concerned about how much aluminum I'm gonna be able to melt before I get to pour anything. I have one piece in there now that's actually laying across the top of it. It's too big to just fall in. It landed sideways, and that's what's holding me back right now. I can't get in there to move it, not without completely shutting the thing off. I'm just really hoping that piece of aluminum is not shielding the liquid underneath. I got another piece in there too. I just went and got a pole. Fixed it. We just got that thing poured. It's just a matter of letting it harden before I can pull it out, just to make sure that this thing worked. That big moment of truth. I did not see the sand collapse when I poured it in. So we should be good. Oh yes, oh yes, look at that. Everything poured exactly like it was supposed to. Oh yes, oh man, I just ruined that tarp. Oh well, we didn't use it for water protection anyways. Set it down right there. Poured exactly like it was supposed to. Look at that. Yes. Oh, that could not have gone any better. All right, so here are the two pieces. I figured I wouldn't record the sanding and using the hacksaw to take it off of the bigger piece because that was long and boring. But if I just drop them into place here, maybe they fall right into place. And I do have a little bit of like gaps between the actual metal piece and the side. So kind of rock back and forth right now because they're not glued in. And again, they're not perfect because they were done by hand. Yeah, super clean. They're flush with the body of the knife. And I was hoping to put the impurities in these. Come on. It's like something like that right there. This impurity used to be a lot bigger. And I was gonna have this side up and it would have this nice big impurity in it. I thought it would look really cool to give it a little bit of character. But when I tried to sand this one last time to make everything nice and uniform,
I ruined it. So I just flipped it over and tried again. And then you got the top piece. So next thing I got to do, and which is the last thing, I got some of this stuff, E6000. I'm going to read the directions and then glue this thing in, and that'll be it.
Not dealing with the chicken.
Going back inside for this one, I guess.
All right, so I have finally finished, let me turn this way so the background's a little more interesting. So I have finally finished building this knife. I've actually been working on this thing for a long time. When I first started it, I took it apart to clean it. And a little bit later, I wrapped one side with the friction tape, just get a nice look. And the plan was to put aluminum in on the other side, which I have done. It has now been glued in with some E6000. Those pieces aren't going anywhere. They're not gonna be coming out. It's very nice, or I think it's pretty nice how it's come out. Anyways, it does give it a pretty good grip. I didn't think it was gonna give it any extra grip, but it does. I think it does make it look a lot better, especially better than just having no pieces there. So you got the friction tape on one side, you got the aluminum on the other. Sharpened blade, titanium. Of course, this thing was sharpened on the belt sander right there. My first time sharpening anything. Next time I sharpen this, I will be getting like proper tools to do this right. But that's it, this thing is built. I really like this thing.
Don't leave me here forever. Don't let me be alone. Just you and me together. Don't let me lose hope.
That's it, really. I'm going to try to turn that into some kind of a video montage type thing. Like the story, or not really story, but I guess you could say that, it sounds cooler. The story of rebuilding this knife, I guess you can say. Dismantling it, cleaning it, sharpening it, and then replacing broken parts, making it look nicer than it was.
Till I die and then put me in the coffin. Don't matter if I'm on the road or if I'm recording. Tell me what you think about me, that really ain't important. You know I'm a representative, I ain't playing, can't afford to. I only got one life, I'ma get it though. And this is not an act, not a movie, not a TV show. I don't know what quit me, I don't never take it slow. You know I'm on the grind, me and Toby in the studio. Go for the king, what you know about that? Say you going harder, I do that. Say you doing work, but you asking where the couch at? How you doing work when you asking where the couch at? You can use them when you wanna. You only look to heaven when you going through some drama. And when they going through some problems, and that's the only time you call them. I guess I don't understand that life. Wonder why, cause I'm all in.